Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 11th episode to create a static website using Bootstrap 4. In the previous episode, we work on blog and today we'll be working on contact us. First of all, let's add a new section after blog. Then to add the title, you can use the title holder div and you can add your title under the s2 tag. Also, you can use the subtitle div if you want to add the subheading. Let's add the comment called contact block and let's add one new class called contact block as well. Once done, you can then refresh the site and you should see a title over here. Then in order to work on this form, we will use the grid and the forms component. So open your Bootstrap website, click on get started, components and forms. Then we will use this example, so I'll just copy this form group and before pasting it over here, I will create a new div with a class called container fluid. And since we got a form tag over here, we will add a form tag over here as well. And if you want, you can add some class name. I will call it contact form. Then you can paste your code over here. Now if we look at the design, we don't have any label over here, so remove this label. And also our input box is just a full name, so instead of the input type email, I'll use input type text. And then I can remove this ID and I can change this placeholder name into interior full name. Once done, you can refresh the site and you should see the input box over here. Since there is three input boxes in one row, we will be using a grid system. So let's add another div with a class called row and again another div with a class called colsm4. Now I will copy this div two more times and then keep on renaming it. The second one is the email, so I will use the input type called email, and instead of the interior full name, it will be interior email address. Then the third one is the contact number, so it should be input type equals tel, and the placeholder will be interior contact number. Now refresh the site and you should see some changes over here. Now let's add the message box. So again, let's create a new row div and this time let's create a new div with a class called colsm12. Then if you want to add the text area, you can copy this code and paste it over here. And again, since we don't have label, you can remove them. You can remove the ID and the rows, but instead you can add the placeholder called interior message. Now the last thing we need to add is this submit button. So let's create new div called BTN holder. Then to add the button, you can click on the button component and you can copy this primary button. The name of the button is submit. Once done, you can refresh the site and your form is looking exactly the same as in our design. Now let's add this Google map. So just after this container fluid div, let's create a new div called Google map. Then to get the iframe of the Google map, you can go to google.com/maps. You can then add your location over here, click on share, embed the map. You can copy this iframe and paste it over here. If you want the width to be 100%, you can add the width over here, or if you want to adjust the height, you can change it over here. You can remove all the other attributes. Once done, you can refresh the site again and you should see a Google map over here. Finally, let's add this contact information now. So just after this Google map div, let's create another div with a class called container fluid. Then let's create another div called the contact info. Then to add this information, I want to use the onOrder list. So let's use ULLI. Then let's copy all this information. And you can get these icons from the Font Awesome website, but for now I will use my developer tool and copy each of them. Once done, you can refresh the site. Now, contact us is looking exactly the same as in our design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on the footer. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.